Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this LG Flatron W2241S. This power supply board, it is not powering on the next motherboard. The problem here that this board is fluctuating. Let's supply power. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair, because it have live electrical voltage. I will use series lamp to apply power. I also downloaded the circuit diagram for this board, and we will see where is the fault and how we can fix it. First we will see the fault condition. Now the board is powered on. Never touch any component when the power is applied, especially the primary side, the hot area. Set multimeter to DC voltage and check voltage across rectifiers. This is secondary side and it is fluctuating. The second rectifier, the same condition, 22 volt rectifier. This inverter power supply, it is also fluctuating, and this rectifier 17 volt, it is also fluctuating. If you see the optocoupler primary side, LED side, it is fluctuating, and if you see this rectifier, that is auxiliary winding rectifier, it is also fluctuating. If we check the main capacitor, it is 340 volts. Set multimeter to AC. It is 237 volts. 237 multiply 1.414, 335. If we have voltage around 335, set multimeter to DC and check voltage here. 339, that is exactly around 335 volts. That means the capacitor is good. Sometimes the capacitor is internally opened or its material is weak. At that time this capacitor is also a reason for fluctuation. But this time capacitor is good. Now if we check VCC capacitor here, it is also fluctuating. That means the problem is in feedback network. The MOSFET is switching and transformer is working good. We are finding fluctuation here. That means this circuit is affected. Let's start. Now we checked that output voltage are available. The problem in feedback. In feedback, first we will check the voltage at pin number 1 of this IC, that is STR voltage. These STR voltage that are provided from the main rectifier through this resistor, 47 kilo ohm resistor. Pin number 5 of this IC, FAN7601, is ground. So we will check between pin number 1, this is pin number 1, it is 294 volt. That means the STR voltage are available. That's good. Then we need to check the feedback that is coming from optocoupler. From here we need to check pin number 2. Pin number 5 ground, pin number 2, it is fluctuating. Feedback pin that is controlled by this optocoupler, it is making problem. Pin number 3 soft start, pin number 4 RTCT, 5 ground, 6 output, and pin number 7. 5 ground, 6 out, 7 number is VCC, ground and 7. Pin number 7 is VCC. VCC is fluctuating. That means this IC is now in reboot mode. And if we check pin number 8, that is reference voltage, because we have fluctuation at pin number 7, that is VCC pin. So it is the problem that reference voltage will drop as well. So we need to verify the VCC section, because VCC, optocoupler and feedback. If we see the loop, pin number 1 of the transformer is ground, then we have resistor, diode, and it is reaching to VCC pin, and this VCC is going to feedback. So we have problem 1, VCC pin and the feedback pin. Before touching to board, verify the voltage on this capacitor, it must be discharged. So it is 8.6 volt. Now if we see the circuit, this auxiliary winding, it is grounded, and this end is coming to resistor R111, and then we have a rectifier, and after rectifier this voltage will reach to VCC pin, and then this VCC is connected to optocoupler. If our voltage are good from here, if our voltage are good from this side, at that time it must provide feedback when it will switch. So we have something wrong here or here. Let's check it. We have this winding, this winding, two rectifiers. This is our positive side, this is ground, and yes, this winding, this end is connected to R111. It's 520, no, check in reverse polarity, no, it is 5, it must be 4.7 ohms. If winding and 4.7 ohms, then it will go to rectifier, the rectifier D102 is here in diode mode. Reverse polarity, so this diode is good. That means our this rectifier, this resistor is bad. If resistor is bad, it is open circuit, it will not allow to pass the voltage. Let's open it and verify it. I will open from one end. Yes, our this resistor is open. In the diagram it is saying 4.7. Okay, we will use 4.7 ohms and then we will see the result. The actual color is brown, black, golden. I have 4.8 ohms. I will connect as per the diagram. Or we can use the physical one ohm resistor. Brown, black, golden. Now I am connecting first for trial purpose 4.7 ohms, because in the diagram, technical manual, it is showing 4.7 ohms. Now we can check. It is 4.9 ohms with the original 1 ohm resistor, brown, black, golden. It was giving 522 kilo ohms, but now the resistor is good. We can check it. And when there is fluctuation in the system, always verify these components. Diode, resistor, and RCD's number. Now if we check this diode with parallel to this gate resistor, so we need to verify this diode and this resistor. If it is open, that means this diode have no effect, but if it is connected that time, it will give a direct signal to the gate and it will make problem. Might be this is the problem to damage the VCC network. This is diode, it is short circuit, and this resistor 4.7 ohms, it is open because this time it is measuring in parallel resistance from this point to this point across here. This end is connected here and this end is connected through this. So our this component set is also damaged. And 4148. Okay, now I will connect this resistor here. Now I am connecting this diode here and this resistor in series with this diode. Now let's power it on and then we will see the condition. DC voltage. Now we can check the voltage. I applied line voltage and set multimeter to DC voltage. Here we have 5.184 regulated, 183 that is regulated. Before this it was jumping too much, but now it is stable, 5.184. check 22 volt section. Now it is stable. Check this 17 volts. It's okay now. So the problem here, it was this resistor was open. Might be it was due to any reason. If this diode is damaged, if it is damaged at that time, might be it makes too much switching, and at that switching this resistor become open. I connected 4.7 ohm resistor. The physical it was 1 ohm resistor. And now the IC is working normal. So the problem that this resistor was open. This diode, this resistor. 1, 2, 3 components were bad and this IC was going in reboot mode. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.